Inchai Comic Guy here, and we have today our follow-up to She Return of the Warrior. Now, I did get my digital copy of the comic book, and we're going to go ahead and we're going to take a look at this. Since my initial review, I've had a chance to go ahead and do some additional research. And one of the big things I wanted to look into was packaging, because with such a large size print actually coming in the mail, was there a better option available to Billy Tucci and his team? Going over to my local post office, I discovered that the answer to that question is no. There was no economically better way of actually sending this print. And well, okay, actually there was, but it wasn't a viable option. Billy Tucci's alternative would have been to roll up the print and stick it in a tube. And while it may have been possible to shove all this stuff into a tube, number one, economically it's not going to be viable, and number two, nobody wants to get their print curled into a circle. So getting it the way it was sent actually was the best option available for Billy Tucci, and he did go that step further, putting the actual print inside of a hard plastic sheath in order to make sure that it didn't get destroyed. So I'm actually going to revise my initial score, and I'm going to give the packaging a 4 out of 5, because this was the best option that Billy Tucci had available to him without customizing every box in order to go ahead and send it to his patrons. So with that in mind, Billy Tucci's packaging, we're bumping that from a 3 to a 4 because it was the best option available. As noted previously, the cover artwork, which in this case is the print itself, is certainly a 4 out of 5. It is absolutely gorgeous. It's hanging on my wall right now. You may notice that I'm actually using footage from my initial unboxing, and that's mostly because I don't want to take it off my wall, which I think is kind of a high compliment all in and of itself. So this brings us to what we've been waiting for, and that is a review of the interior artwork. And I'm going to show a couple of stills from the PDF file that I received. And as you can see, the interior artwork is absolutely gorgeous. This book has to be judged a little bit differently than a lot of my other books. Kyrie could be judged based off of the artwork because it's something that I hadn't seen before. When taking a look at Cyberfrog, it's important to remember that this is a book that really hasn't seen print since the 1990s. Ethan Van Sciver made the book, then he became a pro, and then he stopped making the book. It's very, very different when talking about She, because Billy Tucci has been producing She for years. I mean, She's been a major character in the comic book world since its debut. I mean, it originally came out in 1993. The regular series, the first miniseries, I should say, that came out in 1994. And throughout the whole the 90s going into the 2000s, through the bankruptcy and near collapse of the entire comic book industry, from Image Comics not being able to get their books out on time. And I'm not talking a delay of a couple of months. I'm talking about books that wouldn't come out for years. You've also had the fact that Diamond Distributor basically became the only comic book distributor in the entire industry. Throughout all of this, Billy Tucci has been making his She comic books, which puts me in a very unique situation where I can actually take the original run of She all the way through its sequential runs that occurred in the 90s and early 2000s, the occasional one-shot here and there that was made by Crusade Comics, and take that all the way up to this book. And I think that's one of the things that struck me most about this book, is that it has a legacy. And She, Return of the Warrior, honors that legacy. You can literally go from the original miniseries and jump straight over to this sequel series without missing a beat. Unlike Cyberfrog, this is a clear evolution in artwork, coloring, lettering, storytelling, and you can see how Billy Tucci has evolved in the years that he's been working in the industry. The interior artwork is amazing to look at, and Billy Tucci has approached Xi with the skill of a seasoned veteran. The coloring is fantastic. Unlike most of his contemporaries who over-ink their product because they don't have a lot of faith in the colorists, which, let's face it, back in the 90s and early 2000s, you get a bad colorist on a book, it's going to destroy your book, no matter how good the artwork is. But Billy Tucci approaches it a lot differently here because he knows his team. So the coloring in the books actually complements his artistic style, and he has enough faith in the colors that he works with to not over-ink his books, which also caters to a wonderful level of consistency from the original Xi series all the way up to present, as far as the look and feel of these books and how they just jump off the page, even when Billy wasn't the one who was doing the artwork on some of the series back in the 90s, he was still directing everything. And that wonderful consistency is still here, but evolved and improved and brought to its umpteenth degree in this presentation, and I absolutely love it. So as I said, the interior artwork is a clear 4 out of 5, but the coloring, I'm giving the coloring a 4 out of 5 too, because it is very rare that you see, particularly nowadays, an artist who trusts his colorist so much with his work. To give that colorist an opportunity to complement the pencils and inks created. This brings us to the lettering, and the lettering in this book is a solid 3 out of 5. Now, this is a question I've actually gotten multiple times. People keep asking me, you're always giving letterers 3 out of 5. Why isn't letterers getting a better rating? What can a letter do to get a 5 out of 5? Well, that's simple. You can be Tom Orzechowski. Who's Tom Orzechowski? First off, shame on you. Second off, Tom Orzechowski is the letterer on Spawn. He has been lettering Spawn, I think pretty consistently, since it originally came out in the early 90s. And his lettering is the gold standard for letterers. I have not seen anyone in any comic book do a better job at lettering than Tom. Tom's lettering in Spawn redefined lettering in the industry. And there are few letterers out there who do as good a job as Tom. So when I look at a comic book, that is what I judge you against. If your work is as good or better, which I have not yet seen, then Tom Orzechowski, you're not getting a 5. Chrono Mechanics almost got a 4, but as we know from that review, there were a couple of problems with the lettering in some places that kind of brought that down so that it didn't reach that high of a level. But the lettering found in Xi Return of the Warrior is a solid 3 out of 5. It is professional work that you would expect from any comic book, mainstream, independent, or Comicsgate. Now we come to the writing, and the writing once again is absolutely fantastic. I was engrossed in this story from the first page to the last page. Billy Tucci approaches the art of writing as a veteran pro. He knows exactly how to put his story together. He successfully reintroduces us to the characters, adhering to the classic quote from Stan Lee, "Every comic book is somebody's first comic book." And Billy Tucci reintroduces us to Xi in an absolutely impeccable, fantastic style. We know who she is. We get a sense of her personality. We get a sense of the world that she lives in, of the dichotomy that she has as somebody who is caught between her Christian faith and her upbringing as a Japanese warrior. We see how her life has evolved, going from being a young woman fighting crime to now being a mother and a business person and having to deal with all those unique challenges that come with her life, especially raising a daughter on her own. I won't go into a lot of the details about the story because this is something I don't want to spoil. I want you to go find this book. Now, just so you know, Billy Tucci right now is rebuilding his eBay store. So when his eBay store is up and running again, you have to go get this book. If you were unfortunate enough that you missed getting She, Return of the Warrior, you have got to get this because it is one of the very, very best written stories that I have found in all of Comicsgate. Which frankly makes perfect sense because Billy Tucci has been an independent comic book creator before it was stylish. He was out there making his own books on his own terms before Image Comics was really a thing. And while Billy Tucci would work with the mainstream, he never sold out to the mainstream. He never sold She to some faceless corporation a la Disney just to make a quick buck. She, then as it is now, is Billy Tucci's creative property. And hopefully, it always will be. So as I said, I'm giving the writing in She, Return of the Warrior a 4 out of 5. At this point, I would usually sit back and give you a final score, but we have a 7th category that must be addressed with this comic book. And that 7th category, which we don't see very often, in fact, this will be the first time that we'll be seeing it in one of my reviews, is customer service. Now, most of the time, customer service is not going to come up as an issue in any review for a Comicsgate book because you place your order, it gets fulfilled, it reaches you, you're done. Yeah, your comic book may show up late, but you know, hey, these things happen. We got books showing up late in the mainstream. You don't think it's going to happen with independent comic book creators? You're crazy. But that does bring up other issues. Because these books are coming to you in the mail, you might have a situation where it's damaged, you might have a situation where the packaging ruptured and it got wet and that ruined your comic book, or something to this effect, and customer service suddenly becomes a big issue. And I had a customer service experience with regards to She, Return of the Warrior, and I freely admit up front, this is all my fault. So let me go ahead and break this down for you. Number one, I screwed up. Me. I screwed up and hit the wrong link when ordering my book and ordered the print instead of the actual comic book itself. And I am certainly not going to blame Billy Tucci for my mistake. The second mistake, and again, this is me, is that I order a lot of things through Indiegogo, so I get a ton of emails from Indiegogo. So many that I have a dedicated folder set off just for email for Indiegogo. And I thought that Billy Tucci would be sending a separate email to me with the link to get my book. I didn't realize that the link would be coming through Indiegogo. So I didn't realize that the link was actually sitting right there for me. When I went to go look at the folder and just make my way through that mountain of emails that I received from Indiegogo, I found the link in one of the messages, but the link was broken because they had already closed out the availability of the book through that link. As I continued looking through all the links, I discovered that they did a relaunch of the digital copy for people who backed She, Return of the Warrior, and I had a link that I can click right there. But I did have to go through a lot of searching to find it because, well, I buy a lot of Comicsgate books and I'm waiting on a metric ton of comic books to come from Indiegogo. But you know what? That was never going to be an issue. I actually went and looked just for my own knowledge to find out what had gone wrong and just to affirm that it really was my screw up. But you know what? I never had to worry about that because when Billy Tucci heard that I didn't get my digital copy of the book, he reached out to me personally and he made everything right. He gave me a link to go get a copy of my book, thanked me for my time, and conducted himself as a perfect gentleman. And I have to admit, I was blown away by how amazing the customer service experience was with Billy Tucci and his team in helping me resolve a problem that I, again, freely admit, is my own darn fault. And I freely admit, it could have gone sideways. I mean, I would not have been surprised to have gotten a catty response from another creator. I mean, I could just imagine the kind of response I could have gotten from somebody like Heather Antos.
Like, oh my God, you don't know how to use email? We sent that to you. Why don't you look in your spam folder before you bother me about things like this? I mean, gosh, don't you know how to internet? Ugh, you're such a millennial.
I mean, if I had gotten a message like that, I freely admit, I kind of would have deserved it. I really would have. But the thing about Comicsgate is built on certain principles, certain values. And you get these people who are detractors from the Comicsgate community who are like, oh, LOL, you have values. Yes, Comicsgate has values. And that core value is customer first. We don't have the likes of Heather Antos and Chip Zdarsky, who are sitting there lampooning fans for daring to ask them when a book's coming out. And by and large, even when fans are being a-holes, and yes, I know, I personally abuse the privilege on occasion, even when fans are not at their best, typically speaking, Comicsgate producers are. And if you say or do something to rile up a Cecil or John Malin that you do get lampooned on Twitter or Facebook or wherever, chances are you deserved it. Because the customer first philosophy of Comicsgate means that does not happen without provocation, and it does not happen very often. So with Billy Tucci, an absolutely amazing customer service experience, I'm giving customer service a 5 out of 5. He helped me fix my problem, didn't judge me for my own screw-ups, and was so unbelievably gracious. Billy Tucci really is one of the very best people in all of Comicsgate. And this gives She Return of the Warrior a final score of 4 out of 5. It is tied with Kyrie for being the best comic book that I have gotten from Comicsgate. Thank you, Billy Tucci, for helping me get my comic book and for producing such an amazing work. And for everybody else, I want to remind you, the campaign for Billy Tucci's sequel to She Return of the Warrior, Hayako, is available right now on Indiegogo. So get over there, click on the link, and buy yourself a copy of She, Hayako, today. Thank you, every single one of you, for coming by and watching this video and supporting Billy Tucci and all of his fantastic work. I know that he appreciates you, and I appreciate all of you too.